This is the prayer request.
And school.
For this school, yeah.
God's protection against disease. Oh. Huh.
Alright friends, we just want to welcome you tonight. We're about to start here in another minute or so. We're going to start another short service tonight. We're so excited to be with you. I think I might need to adjust this camera a little bit. Thank you, Lord. Adjust this a bit. Let's try that there. Okay. Ah, Kathy! It's good to see you.
Yes, Sister Kathy.
Rose? Sister Rose, nice to see you.
Amen.
Praise God. Bless you. Now we have mics today, both of us, so you guys can hear us.
Exactly.
Amen. It's an honor to see you guys.
Yeah, sure.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, you're in the Congo. Oh, yes, we will keep you guys in prayer. Tonight we believe the power of God will come and touch your situation. Thank you so much for that update, sister.
Amen. Well, from Congo, yeah.
Yes. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
He invites people.
Amazing family of God. Cynthia, it's nice to see you.
Amen.
Naomi, I hope you guys are doing well.
Thank you.
Thank God for you guys. Debbie.
Debbie, Sister Debbie, God bless you.
God bless you guys so much for all the things you're doing in the kingdom. We just want to honor God in you.
Yeah.
God is doing wonderful things. Well, I think it's... Are we at 7 o'clock? Pastor John, is it 7?
Exactly 7 p.m.
Awesome, guys. Welcome tonight. As we head into another session tonight.
Yes.
And I call it Transformation Tuesday.
Yes.
Transformation Tuesday. We believe that tonight God will transform us from the inside out and our situation. One thing I'm learning and recognizing is that when Jesus changes something inside of me and he transforms my heart.
Yes.
Something also transforms in my situation. Uh-huh. Because often we don't recognize that what we see is based on who we are inside, and as Jesus changes us into who he has called us to be, we start to see our situation different, and we treat it different, and our situation responds to the power and the word of God.
Yes.
Pastor John, do you want to open in prayer?
Yeah, let's pray.
Amen.
Our God and our Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, this evening or this night,
yes,
let your power manifest to everyone who is watching us online. Touch each and every person.
Yes.
Open ear of the Spirit that they can hear everything that the Spirit is going to direct today.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Okay.
Thank you, God.
Amen.
I just appreciate you, brother.
Thank you.
Dan, oh, it's so awesome to see you, brother. You know, me and Dan, we grew up, we played chess all the time.
Yes.
We played lots of games of chess. And you know, now we just watch as God plays chess in our life and he conquers our old self. Amen. Praise God. Amen. We're so excited that Jesus made the way for us all.
Amen.
Amen. All right. We're going to go to the book of John tonight. If you have your Bibles, I think it'd be nice to do that declaration tonight.
Yeah, because yesterday we said that we have to pray. So many people send the requests.
Amen.
So today is the day that we are going to pray and to do something that God is going to answer.
Praise God. We just thank Jesus so much. Wow. Amen. And so, yeah, if you guys send your prayer requests tonight, we will take them.
Yes.
But as we get into the book of John, tonight is Transformational Tuesday. And, yes. And one thing that I just was on my heart is abide. All night as I was in my bed, thinking and praying and resting in the Lord, I just heard the word abide keep coming to me, abide. And I was reminded of the words of Jesus. Uh-huh. And so tonight we want to really get in a position where we abide in him, because what happens is when we abide in Jesus, it changes us on the inside.
Exactly.
It releases us from fear. It releases us from worry.
Yeah.
It releases us even from just the issues of sin maybe that we've struggled with in our life.
Uh-huh.
And so as we keep going and we rest and we stay in that place in Christ, we become transformed.
Yes.
And oh, wow. I just see that your situation will be touched by the power of God.
Yes.
As you rest in Christ. So let's go to John chapter 15.
John 15.
But just before we read, if you have a Bible or a Bible app, I just want love lifting my Bible to heaven is a declaration to God about his word and our situation. So if you have your Bible, just lift it with me. And we're going to say, this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
The word of God.
The word of God.
God never fails.
God never fails.
He never lies.
He never lied.
I am who he says I am.
I am who he says I am.
And I can have what he says I can have.
I can have who he says that I can have.
And I can do what he says I can do.
I can do what he says that I can do.
Amen.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
I love it. Thank you, God. So John chapter 15, verse 4 tonight. We're going to start at verse 4.
Okay.
And it says this, abide in me. Uh-huh. This is Jesus talking. Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself,
uh-huh,
unless it abides in the vine,
yes,
neither can you bear fruit unless you abide in me.
Powerful.
That's a powerful scripture.
That is powerful.
Let's read the verse 5 now.
5.
So he says that you have to abide or live in the vine. Uh-huh. Now he says, I am the vine,
uh-huh,
and you are the branches.
Yes.
The one who abides inside of me,
uh-huh,
and me in him, I in him,
yes,
bears much fruit.
Uh-huh.
For without me, you can do nothing.
Yes.
How many of you have tried? How many of you have worried at times? Uh-huh. And you know, it didn't change the situation.
Exactly.
It didn't help anything. No matter how much you worry.
Yeah.
If you worry 10 minutes a day. Uh-huh. Or if you worry 20 hours a day.
Exactly.
It didn't change the situation.
Uh-huh.
You still accomplished nothing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Except getting yourself depressed.
Yeah.
And worried.
Uh-huh.
And you gave place to the devil. Here's the thing, if we abide in Jesus,
uh-huh,
we are going to bear fruit.
Exactly.
So, first of all, the fruit of the Holy Spirit,
uh-huh,
is love.
Yes.
And it's joy.
Yes.
And it's peace.
Yeah.
Wow, it's faithfulness, kindness, goodness, gentleness, self-control.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Man.
Hallelujah.
So many fruits of the Holy Spirit. Yeah.
Yes. So, yeah. If we are bearing fruit, whose fruit is it? Is it our fruit or is it the Holy Spirit's fruit?
It's the Holy Spirit.
So it's the work of God inside of your life that transforms you.
Exactly.
On this Tuesday, tonight, if you will learn to abide in Jesus, you will bear fruit of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
It's the work of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And you know what I love is when I read that, this is an indicator of how God wants to treat us.
Amen.
With love. Amen. With kindness, with patience, with goodness, with gentleness, with self-control. You know, this is actually how God sees us and wants to have a relationship with us. See, this is why we have to understand the love of God. Because when we see it, then we can receive that God wants to do some wonderful goodness for our life.
Amen.
Instead of saying, no, God, I don't deserve it. Now, we in ourselves don't, but through Jesus Christ, God has made us worthy to receive, to be the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
So I'm going to go on.
Let's continue with us.
We will continue. Amen. Okay, so. Right now, God has given us a window to test our faith. See, in verse 6, it says this, if a man does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. What I want to focus on right now isn't maybe exactly what it's saying here, but what I want to say is every person goes through a test.
Exactly.
Everything is tested by fire.
Yes.
And all of us have to go through tests. And the powerful thing here is what I recognize is through those tests, we can see if we can bear fruit or not.
Yes.
We're going to see what stands and what remains and what is taken away when we go through the test. Everything that we lose in the test was something that didn't need to be there in our life. Praise God. So everybody goes through a test, and those who bear fruit are kept safe and sound in Jesus. Their life becomes a testimony in the test. At the end of the test, they have something to say about their God. They have something to say about their God conquering and bringing them through the situation. It's powerful. You know, too often, I think people throw away their testimony. They throw out their reputation to carry. You know, we're supposed to carry the reputation of God. We're supposed to represent Him. If I talk faith, but I have no fruit. You know what? I believe when it says here, men gather up the sticks and throw them in the fire, that's because they're worthless. See, my testimony, when I'm in the test, it's so important that I bear fruit.
Amen.
Because if I don't and I throw it all away and I don't have the fruit of the Spirit, you know what? My words become meaningless to people. They will throw out my testimony.
Exactly.
They'll throw out everything I say because there's no fruit to back it up.
That is true, Pastor.
Wow. You have something to add to that, Brother John?
No, first to continue or what?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So right now, God has given us a window of opportunity in this time to test our faith to see if it is genuine. And it doesn't mean you should feel like a failure if it doesn't work out or if you feel like you messed up. Don't feel like a failure. Don't give up. Because part of the fruit coming out of you is standing, is staying in the Lord, letting His power keep you. If we stay focused on the Word of God without being pulled from what is really important, and then look what Jesus says next, what's going to happen. John 15, verse 7, if you, someone say me, it's my choice. If I abide in Jesus and His words abide in me, you shall ask. Who shall ask? You and me. We shall ask whatever you will. Who? Whatever you will. Whose will? Our desires. And it shall be done unto you.
Exactly.
Wow. You know, that really hit me. I was thinking about all the parents with children. If you have children that honor and obey you, children that respect you, you know what? You as a parent, you want to do everything you can to bless them.
Exactly.
You can't wait. You almost want to let them out of their chores so you can bless them.
Yeah.
You wanna find out their desires and you wanna gift them things, you know?
Yes.
But if that same child is always fighting and arguing you and not respecting your rules, all that they have is correction and arguments and discipline coming.
Yeah. Yeah.
But see, Jesus is saying if we abide in him, that means if we love him and we want to honor his word, and we believe it, it means that God loves it so much.
Exactly.
He wants to give you every desire you pray for.
And anything it's, that you want, him, his name is going to give
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Because you abide.
Aha.
Yeah.
See, you're already living that he knows your priority is to put him number one place.
Yeah, exactly.
And
it's
to
like
obey
magnets
him.
Magnets and metal.
Exactly.
If they are together.
Magnet and metal.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so God all of a sudden turns and he says, now it's not just what I will, but what do you desire?
Yeah.
Because he knows your heart. If your heart is after him first, he's going to grant you your request tonight.
Amen.
See, if you've committed your heart to God tonight to say, God, I just want to obey you and everything you want to do, Father, I just want to bless and honor your word above everything.
Mm-hmm.
And what God says is, you know what? Then I want to also honor your desires.
Yes.
I want to bless you.
Mm-hmm.
I want to take care of you.
Mm-hmm.
I want to prosper you. I want to heal you.
Yeah.
You know, it's the will of God.
Yeah.
And I know that, and I'm not here to have an ego. I want you guys to know that. I'm not here to brag on myself because I didn't earn any of this.
Mm-hmm.
But Jesus paid for it.
Amen.
See, when I grew up, I thought that for years, that every single time I felt sick, I had a condition that I had bowel problems and lots of pain. But every time I felt sick, I thought God was judging me every single time because I messed up.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not saying that the consequences or the wages of sin is death.
Mm-hmm.
And it brings death to our bodies, even in a sense of sickness comes through sin.
Yes.
You know, so many of us, we've come to believe that sickness is just something in the earth that comes up. And some people believe it's all only demonic. Now I believe the devil's involved in sickness and trying to spread it.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, other people think God invents it, you know. But let's just look at this for a second. See, I remember reading in the Old Testament when Israel sinned, and there were times where sometimes, you know, they were under a curse or something happened, but you know what? As soon as they repented, God didn't leave them in their problem.
Yeah.
God had a plan to rescue them.
Exactly.
You know, and so what God did with me was he rescued me out of this illness I had. And sometimes what's frustrating is so often we profess something, we profess the Bible to be true, but when it comes to declaring it by faith as a solid thing we stand on, we back off. See, I was at a meeting that God paid for me to go to for one whole week of meetings, and in those meetings God completely healed me of the problem. And I did not miss a day of work thanks to God's power. For like about 10 years, I worked at that place. And I don't think I had one sick day after God healed me.
Yes.
And the thing is, I recognized it was the will of God. Because when I get to heaven, I don't believe that God has anything but his perfect will in heaven.
Exactly.
And so in heaven it says there will be no sorrow, no pain, no disease, no sickness.
No anything.
Nothing like that. Now, because there's no pain or sorrow, God will wipe their tears. That means there's nothing to cause you to have a problem in heaven.
Exactly. Only joy.
Only joy. Oh, man. Can you imagine the fullness of joy, the fullness of peace, just even all at the same time?
Yeah.
in its extremis. Oh man, that's exciting stuff. So God healed me. And I remember going to the hospital one time and praying for a guy. And I had to face that fear because I thought, man, if this is the will of God, then I need to at least do my part. The results aren't always up to me. Now, our faith, we need to contend for things. But I prayed for a guy, and he was limping. And I asked him what was wrong with his leg, and he said he had a hip problem. And so when I prayed for him, I said, take my hand. And you know what I did was I came to God and I said, God, I don't know that I have faith for this.
Yeah.
But I know that the pastor I'm working under has faith for this. Lord, would you honor his faith?
Yeah.
Lord, honor his faith.
Mm-hmm.
And I just said, take my hand. And I said, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And I just believed God's anointing was released.
Amen.
And the guy looks at me like I'm weird, like I'm different. And I said to him, I said, you know what? Why don't you take a step? And he's confused. He's looking at me. I was afraid to be clear with him.
Yeah.
Because I was afraid that if it didn't work, I would look bad.
Yeah.
Right? But I finally inside of me, God says, tell him to walk.
Amen.
And to try out.
Yeah.
See,
exercise.
Faith is faith. Has to have action.
Exactly.
And so for them to have faith in what you say, they need to act as well. And so when he started walking, maybe he took about 14 steps, I believe it was. At about step 7 or 8, I realized he wasn't limping anymore.
Man.
And so I said, hey, how does it feel? And he spun around. He said, all the pain's gone. I just...
Wow, praise God.
And he said, who are you? See, we're a representative of Jesus.
Yes.
And I just gave glory to Jesus. And I said, listen, man, it's not too important who I am. What's important is you know that Jesus came and died for your sin. And I shared with him the gospel. And for 45 minutes, he's weeping outside of the hospital, confessing all of his sins to me. I'm, you know... The Bible says we're a royal priesthood. Amen. Jesus, the high priest.
Exactly.
And I said, man, all you got to do is tell Jesus. He's going to wash it away. He said, no. And he had a problem. The spirit of condemnation was on him.
Amen.
Because he did some things that he did not believe God could forgive him for. And I said, that's not true. That's a lie. But isn't it amazing that we pray for people for years and years and years. And sometimes we just need to act on the leading of God.
Yes.
And not be afraid when God puts a situation in front of us. Because that might just be that person's chance for salvation.
Yeah.
That might be your chance to see it, have a front row seat to a miracle that God does.
Amen.
But there's risk involved. There's a risk to your reputation. And the Bible says we shouldn't try to preserve ourselves. Or to love ourselves, even if it means death.
Yeah.
And so that's something that I'm constantly working on. And some days I feel like I'm there, and some days I don't know if I am ready for that.
Yeah.
But it says here, whatever you ask, it shall be done unto you. So if you have a prayer request tonight, we want to take that to the Lord in prayer.
Yeah.
But I want one more scripture, John 15:10.
15:10, yeah.
If you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love.
Yes.
Wow.
If you keep
them.
The commandments.
It's like living in them.
Yeah.
You know.
That means there is command.
Uh-huh.
There is command
exactly.
That we need to follow.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. You know, when Jesus came to live in you, inside of you by his spirit, when you ask God to save you, God didn't just walk into your house, your body, but with his spirit, and just get the keys to the place and walk in and just is standing there. It says that he wants to abide in us. You know, he moved right in.
Yeah.
When you move into a house, you don't just go for a visit.
Yeah.
You just don't go for a visit. You bring all of your stuff. You bring all of your food, your couches, your beds, Yeah. You know, the Holy Spirit came to live inside of you.
Yes.
This is good. God has furnished us inside, in our spirit where He lives in us.
Yes.
God came to furnish us.
Amen.
And you know, what He's saying is, He wants all of us, who we are, to come and live inside of His Word.
Exactly.
He wants our life. He wants our life to be totally surrounded with the Word of God. Exactly. Immersed in the Word of God. It's like we want to pattern our life after the Word of God.
Amen.
Jesus said that if we hear His words but we don't apply them to our life, that we're like a house that's built on sand with no foundation.
Exactly. You can't. Yeah, you can't build on sand. You must build on the rock.
On the rock.
Because and that's, the rock is the foundation.
Exactly. That is
Jesus Christ Himself.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's it. It's but we have to listen to His words. And like you said, there comes obedience.
Exactly.
There's a command to obey. Mm-hmm. But obedience is so easy when you love someone.
Exactly.
It's so easy to honor someone when you love them. Mm-hmm. It's powerful.
Yes.
So let's just look at what we have for prayer requests coming in.
Before prayer requests, I think I have the word that God has laid in my heart today.
Amen.
Yeah, maybe the prayer requests. We have almost 6 minutes to go.
Yeah, we got, well, we can go as long as God wants us to.
Okay. This word is the word of you. You are watching online, because this is the weight that God has laid in my heart today. That for the new beginning, because there is door of new beginning.
Amen. That's exactly.
That's the weight or the message that God has given me today, that we are going to discuss on that, or we are going to talk on that. According to Pastor, that Jesus is the rock and Jesus Christ is the truth.
Yes.
Because Jesus Christ, if He's the truth, that means everything that we are doing, there is answer. Because truth is the answer of Amen. Everything that we are doing.
Amen.
Because if you have a problem, you look for solution.
Yes.
You look for the answer.
Amen.
Now, there is no anywhere that you can find answer. It's only in Jesus.
Amen.
That you can find answer.
Yeah.
Now, today, because this word came to me very hard in my heart. I'm going to give the scripture, but before I give you the scripture, you know, there is door of opportunity. You know, in exactly. life, when one door closes, another door is open for your opportunity. Because every door can't close together. There is way that you can found to other door that you can found your blessing.
Amen.
It's not every door. If every door is closed, that means you need to seek the face of God. Because God is always open door for you, that you can see the blessing, you can see the goodness of God in that sight.
Wow.
For us, I think we are going straight to the Bible because of the time.
Sure.
Yeah, 2 Kings chapter 5. Chapter 5. We are going to read one, but we are going to go just little by little until we go to the point.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, before, you know, in life, You can be in good health, but there is something inside of you is going down. You can have a lot of money, but you can have something that is not good. You can have a very good appetite, but if you finish eating, if you go to your bed, you start crying. That means there is something inside of you that is not good.
Yes.
This scripture that we are going to read is scripture that everyone know, this scripture of Captain or Naaman.
Right.
Because Naaman he had everything. He had health, he had soldiers, he had lot of things.
Exactly.
But there was something that was missing in his life. You can read for us, man of God.
Okay. Which verse?
2 Kings chapter 5, verse 1.
Verse 1.
Yeah.
Now, Naaman, commander of the army of the king of Syria, was a great and honorable man in the eyes of his master.
Was great and honorable man. Was great.
Yes.
And honorable man.
Yes.
Continue.
In the eyes of his master, because by him the Lord had given victory to Syria.
By him the Lord has given victory to Syria.
Wow.
By him, Naaman,
wow,
God has given victory to Syria.
Amen.
He was a great man.
Amen.
Continue.
He was also a mighty man of valor.
Mighty man of valor. Continue, Pastor.
Amen. But.
But.
He was a leper.
Oh, my God. You see? He was a great man. Honorable man.
Yes.
But the Bible continues. But he was a leper. That means there was something that was, you can have so many things, but there is something that you need something that you don't have in your life.
Yes.
But he was a leper.
Wow.
You see?
Yes.
So he have lot of wealth, he had lot of money. He tried everything to go anywhere. Naaman was, this time, we can say he was a billionaire.
Right.
But the Bible says, but he was a leper.
Wow.
Continue, Pastor. Two.
And the Syrians had gone out on raids and brought back captive a young girl from the land of Israel. She waited on Naaman's wife. She was like a servant.
Yeah. You see, they went and captured a young girl. You know, in life, you don't know where your help can come from.
Wow.
You know, this young girl, they capture him. He was a servant to the wife.
Yes.
In that girl, she helped Naaman.
Wow.
Continue, Pastor.
Then she said to her mistress, "If only my master were with the prophet who is in Samaria, for he would heal him of this leprosy."
Amen. You see, he followed the channel. She didn't go straight to the master.
Yes.
She went to the wife of Naaman. She followed the channel.
Right.
It was very easy because she saw Naaman that he was a leper.
Yes.
And that girl, she has the answer inside of her.
Yeah, exactly. Wow.
You see? She tell the wife, if Naaman go to the man of God.
Right.
By the prophet. You can have an answer.
Wow. Amen. It's powerful.
It's powerful. Indeed, it's powerful.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. So, you see, in the journey that we are going, if we say that we are a Christian, we know God, there is channel that we need to follow.
Yes.
We need to follow certain channel. Don't go straight or don't go shortcut. You need to follow certain channel to reach for your destiny.
Wow.
You know, your destiny, you can, you know, Naaman was a great man in not so many people.
Yes.
But he didn't expect that his deliverance can have it right through that girl.
Servant, yeah.
That servant. You see? Continue, Pastor. Oh, no, we have to jump.
Okay.
We have to jump. Just a minute. Okay. Let's go to 10 because of time.
Okay. And time. Elisha sent a messenger to him saying, go and wash in the Jordan 7 times and your flesh shall be restored to you and you shall be clean.
Okay. I'll stop first there. You know, Naaman was a great general.
That's right.
The time that was going to the prophet of God, amen, he took his soldier, he took a lot of things. If yes, we go in that scripture, he took a lot of things. He was expecting if he meet the prophet and prophet can anoint him or maybe can pray to him or maybe can do something that Naaman can have his miracle there.
Yes.
When he went there and the prophet sent people, go and tell him.
Yeah.
He didn't even saw him face to face. No, amen, go and tell him.
Yes.
To go and wash himself 7 times.
Wow.
You see, and Naaman knows better. He knows the nice river. This river they are telling me it's not a very good river. And the servant said, no, you must follow. Yes. The word of the servant, the word of the prophet, you must go. Chronicle 2020. First read Chronicle 2020, Pastor.
First or second Chronicle?
Oh, second Chronicle 2020.
Second Chronicles
20
verse 20.
Yeah.
Okay, it says here, and they rose early in the morning and went into the wilderness of Tekoa.
Second Chronicles 20:20?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
And they went into the wilderness of Tekoa, and as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God, so shall you be established. Believe his prophets, so shall you prosper.
Amen. Believe in the word of prophet. Prophet said, go and dump yourself 7 times in the river Jordan.
Yeah. That's right, yeah. Amen.
You know, 7 is a number of God. And he went to the river.
Yes.
What happened? Wait, Pastor.
Well, he was offended. Naaman was furious.
Yeah. Because he didn't expect. He was expect the prophet of God to pray. Maybe to anoint him.
Yes.
His expectation was not the expectation of God.
Amen. Wow.
Or his thinking was not the thinking of God.
That's right.
the way of God is different than the way that we can think ourselves.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, let's go 14. The second King 14. The second King chapter
5 verse 14.
14, yeah. You are so, going to read 12?
Yeah, no.
Oh, 12. 12.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Are not the Abana and the Pharpar, the rivers of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel?
Yeah.
Why can't I wash in them and be clean?
You see?
So he turned and went away in a rage.
Mm-hmm. You see? You're thinking to another river.
Uh-huh.
That is better than the Jordan River.
Amen. Exactly.
You see? Chronicle, wow. 2 Chronicle 20:20. Believe in God. Believe in prophet.
Come on. Wow. Look at this situation.
You see?
Look at this, guys. The Jordan River was not clean.
Yeah, exactly.
It was not even a desirable river.
Exactly.
And you know how many times God used the Jordan River to bring victory to Israel?
Exactly.
It was like the dirty river. It's like, stay away from that one.
Yeah.
Keep away from that one. We don't even want to touch it.
Uh-huh.
It's probably where all the diseases are.
Yeah.
You know? And Naaman's like, this thing is filthy. I'm not going in there.
Yeah.
He was mad. And look how Israel, God gives them victory in Jericho.
Yeah, exactly.
They had to cross the Jordan.
Yes.
They had to go through what they hated.
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy.
That's it. The Bible said, believe in God, believe in me, prophet.
Oh, boy.
Continue, Pastor.
And his servants came near and spoke to him and said, my father, the prophet had told you to do something great. Would you not have done it?
Yeah.
How much more then when he says to you, wash and be clean? So he went down and listened to them.
Yeah.
And he dipped 7 times in the Jordan.
How many times?
Seven.
7 times in Jordan River. You see?
Wow.
That is 14?
Yes.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Continue up to 17.
According to the saying of the man of God, and his flesh was restored like that of a little child, and he was clean. And he returned to the man of God, he and all his aides, and came and stood before him, and he said, indeed, now I know that there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Now, therefore, please take a gift from your servant.
Amen. I won't touch on gift. I'll touch on gift next time. I think there is someone who's the message. Just send the prayer request. We are going to pray. Just follow the instruction. The way no man followed the instruction. You know, 7 times. First he went number one. Nothing happened.
Nothing.
Number two, zero. Number three, zero. Up to 6, 0.
Yes.
He went 7th time. And the Bible record. His health was restored.
Wow. The skin like a baby.
Yeah, exactly.
Hallelujah.
You know, 7 is the number of God.
Wow. Amazing.
7 is the number of God.
Huh.
It's perfection. It's completion. It's fullness of child.
Wow.
That is number 7. You know, today, you can have a lot of things that you are passing through. I will encourage you, just send your request.
Amen.
And God is going to restore your life.
Amen.
In everything that you are passing through, today God is going to bless you. God is going to heal you.
Amen. Yes.
Don't limit God.
Amen.
Just look upon His greatness, upon
Hallelujah.
His favor, upon everything that God has created, if you see anything that God has created, you see the fullness or goodness of God.
That's right.
You know, Naaman, you didn't expect. You know, sometimes thing that you are expecting that I can receive in this way is not the way of God.
Uh-huh.
Because Naaman was expecting something else, but that something come to a little girl.
Yes.
Who, she was a servant in the house of the Naaman.
Exactly. See, God knows what's in our heart.
Exactly.
God knows
exactly
how to address what's
exactly
in our heart.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. That is the word God has given to me. If one door is closed, the other one is open.
Amen. Amen. So good.
Yeah. This is a door of new beginning. Because today, if you send your request, you are going to start a new life.
Praise God.
Send your request as many you can.
Amen.
I know we have so many requests, but our God is going to answer today.
Amen. God is not limited by a long list.
Amen, amen, amen. Just send the
Hallelujah.
Request. God is going to answer. And going, God is going to.
Amen. So we have one from Rose, Sister Rose.
Yeah.
Pray for us, we're in the Congo.
Yeah.
Ali's brother just passed away.
Oh, sorry to hear
yes.
that.
Yes. Yeah. We send our condolences, sister.
Okay.
We know our God is big to get you through this. And I just say that if his time was cut short, the Lord shall raise him up again.
Amen. Amen.
God
Amen.
Will bring you through this.
Amen.
Okay. We have a testimony. Kathy, testimony. My neck muscles and ear are completely healed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That in the name of
we
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh. Today.
Lebowski?
Yeah.
Brother, we're going to pray for you.
Amen.
Just expect God's power to touch you.
Yes.
And you know what? Act on it. When God touches you, you know what? There's many times when uh-huh. God healed me uh-huh. and I didn't know it until yes. I acted on it. And uh-huh. I all of a sudden just realized that, hey, this is much better now.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
So let's pray for Rose mm-hmm. and Ali's family.
Amen.
Father in heaven, we just yes. come to you.
In the name
we
of
thank
Jesus.
You for the name of Jesus
Lord,
and the blood of Jesus.
Almighty Lord.
Oh, God Almighty Father, we just thank you for this family.
Yes.
We lift
in
them to you.
Jesus.
God, we put them in your hands oh, right now. Holy Spirit, we thank you for blowing resurrection
yes.
light on this situation. Uh-huh. God, I thank you, Lord, that you have all power
yes.
and all authority
uh-huh.
in heaven and in earth. So, Lord, in Jesus' name, God, we thank you, God, for touching the family right now.
Yes.
We thank you, God, you're the provision maker. You're
yes.
the way maker. You're
in
the need
Jesus
meter.
Jesus' mighty name.
God, I thank you in Jesus' name, Father, that everything they need in this season is provided for them.
Yes.
There shall be no, I just hear God saying, you're not going to lack.
Amen.
You will be provided for.
Yes.
Don't
yes.
be in despair.
Yes.
Don't be discouraged.
Yes.
And don't be in fear. God is big.
Mm-hmm.
God is big. And you know what? He can bring money out of a fish.
Yes.
God can do anything. If he can make streets paved with gold, God can do anything.
Yes.
God can make a way for you.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Oh.
Thank you, Father. For your peace.
Yeah, I have one sister here, Sister Bridget.
Sister Bridget?
Yeah, we are going to pray for his school.
School, okay.
Yeah, he needs God to do a miracle in this school.
Okay.
Like to pay school.
Okay, school
like
fees.
To pass exam. Mm. So we are going to pray.
Okay.
It's enough. She's in Africa.
She's in Africa
yeah,
watching. Okay.
Yeah. Even we have one sister from Toronto.
Yes.
She's watching. She said that we have to pray for the family.
Amen.
Another one we have in Toronto again. She said that we have to pray for the family again.
Amen.
Yeah, you need oneness in the family.
Yes.
Yeah, we have sister from Kenya. Or maybe we need to save in the name.
Maybe the first name.
Yeah, it's Solange.
Okay.
Yeah, he's looking for the fruit of womb.
Amen.
Yeah, we have to
get
pray
ready,
that.
Sister. God's bringing it.
We have another one here. It's Caroline.
Okay.
From Botswana.
Yes.
Yeah, she said that she needs the husband.
Okay.
Yeah, she needs God to do the miracle.
Amen.
She needs the husband.
Thank you, Father in heaven.
Yeah, we have another one. Mm. There are many.
Amen. Amen. You know what? I just feel like right now, what's the sister's name? It starts with an S. She's asking God for fruit of the womb.
Caroline.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. We're just going to ask you. You put your hands right now.
Yeah. If you are watching right now,
yes.
Just believe
in
God. The name of Jesus.
That's it.
And in the name of God.
Yes.
And believe also in the servant of God or prophet of God. You are going to receive.
Thank you, Father.
Let us pray. Our God and our Father, yes, according Lord. To your weight.
Yes.
According to your weight, we declare right now, fruit of the womb.
Yes, in Jesus' name.
According to the Bible, Psalms 127, verse 3, children are blessing from God.
Amen.
Right now, every complicated in his womb,
yes.
I rebuke it and I cut it and I operate it in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Loose. Right now.
In Jesus' name.
Receive in the name of Jesus.
Yes. Right now. Receive your miracle. In Jesus' name.
I believe that you have received.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Okay.
There are many requests.
I just see Brother Daniel.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to pray for Brother Daniel. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, we just pray for Daniel right now.
In the name of Jesus.
Our brother.
Yes.
And Lord, we thank you for his life.
Yes.
I thank you, God. I come against every blood pressure issue that might be attacking his body.
Yes.
Father, everything that would attack his heart.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, I command his cholesterol to be normal in Jesus' name.
Yes.
In
Jesus'
name.
Jesus Christ died. Because
Thank
of
you,
that.
Lord. Thank you, Father.
Yes, in the name
Thank
of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Lord, I just speak to his body to be strong
yes.
in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Brother, I just, you know, you check your blood pressure.
Amen.
You check your stuff. You know what? And just, our God is a prayer hearing and answering God. He's heard us.
Mm-hmm.
And it's that easy.
Mm-hmm.
We thank God for that.
Yeah.
Thank you, Father. We pray for our amazing sister, Naomi. She is such a blessing to
Sister
us.
Sister Naomi?
Yes.
Amen.
Her and her husband have been some of our best friends as when we were younger.
Yeah.
In the Lord. And we just love you guys.
Mm-hmm.
We praise God for you. And you know, we just say today, just cast all your cares upon the Lord.
Yes.
The Lord says, I care for you.
Mm-hmm.
And, Thank you, Lord. I just see that your desire is that you would not focus on the problems.
Yes.
But you know, just start by lifting your eyes up.
Yes.
Just begin to see God high and lifted up.
Uh-huh.
Just keep your eyes on Jesus. Keep your eyes fixed on what's happening in the throne room of God.
Yes.
Just keep your focus there. Just keep pushing that focus there.
Oh.
And just don't even give attention. Pay attention to the problem.
Amen.
And God will build your faith as you do this.
Yes.
God will build your faith as you do this. Just keep... Sometimes I've had to draw a line on the horizon. You know, if you've ever been a pilot in a video game, or a real pilot, you know, they always draw a line on the horizon.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a cutoff between Earth and the sky, and that's where they aim for, the horizon, when they fly. And so the thing is, you know, I had to do that one time. There was a, I had a growth happening here. And it kept growing, and I started getting worried.
Yeah.
So I prayed for a number of days, and then God said, get your eyes off the problem and on me. And I just began to, every day for hours and hours, just say, okay, God, I'm not going to look at the problem. Mm-hmm. I look to you, and I remember hearing a message that said, God is your victory.
Yes.
I said, so Lord, I'm looking at you. You're my victory.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, you spoke. In this word, you cannot lie and you never fail.
Yeah.
And so I just kept saying, God, you're not a liar. You don't fail.
Mm-hmm.
And you said that by Jesus' stripes I was healed.
Amen.
And I kept declaring the word of God.
Yes.
And I kept saying, God, you're my victory.
Yes.
You're my healer. You spoke. You never lie. You always keep your word on those who stand on it. And Lord, I refuse to doubt.
Yeah.
I refuse to look at the problem.
Mm-hmm.
And after maybe 1 to 2 weeks of that,
mm-hmm.
one day I heard God say, now, watch the problem leave.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't focus on the problem. The fear couldn't grab a hold of me.
Mm-hmm.
And then eventually God said, now, watch the problem leave.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember for the next number of days watching,
mm-hmm.
bit by bit, as I said, okay, Lord, I thank you that this problem is dissolving, disappearing, and leaving in Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
And I just thanked God. I praised him for it all day, for days. And, you know, sometimes I would literally watch this thing shrink a little bit by a little bit by a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And after not very long, it was completely gone, and I haven't seen it back. That was like 45 years ago, maybe 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So I thank God that, you know, he is my physician, and there's times that it's easier than others to walk in that faith, but I just want to encourage you, lift your eyes to heaven. We just speak strength to your body now. Whatever has been draining your energy, Naomi, we cut that off in Jesus' name. We thank God for mighty strength coming into you from the soles of your feet to the top of your head.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
And we thank God for releasing joy in your life right now.
Mm-hmm.
I thank God that he will take care of your every need. He is big.
Amen.
He's so big. And you know what? He's put a team around you.
Amen.
We believe that you can walk in this victory. And you know what? You just begin to act like it's true. You begin to act like everything you prayed for has come to pass.
Amen.
Just act like it's happened.
Amen.
And you're going to notice a big difference. Thank you, Lord.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Praise God. You have another request?
Yeah, we have so many requests, but we have to pray in general.
Okay.
Yeah, because...
It's too many.
Yeah, it's too many. You know, one thing... You have to look on life of Naaman.
Naaman, yes.
Because Naaman was in critical condition.
Yes, that's right.
But when he followed the instruction,
yes,
and God healed them.
Amen.
I'm going to put in your life right now. You see, we are here.
Amen.
God has given us burden.
Amen.
For your life.
Yes.
We need to pray for your life.
Mm. Amen.
God has signed us that we need to pray for every request, for every situation. Your answer is just believe upon his name.
Amen.
Answer is just believe in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
You are going to see change in your life.
Amen.
Yeah, we are going to pray together for all the requests, because our God is God of everything. But believe, if you send any request, believe that tomorrow, check on that request, you are going to see change in your life.
Yes.
Let us pray again.
Yes, thank you.
Our God and our Father, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Everyone.
Every heart, Lord.
Who has sent the request from us today, touch that request. In spirit, in the name of Jesus.
Everyone right now.
And change his life. Change everything.
Yes.
In his life, in the name of Jesus. I know, Holy Spirit, touch right now.
Yes, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Do your work right now.
Yes, oh God, mighty God. You're awesome.
You just believe in the name of Jesus. You are going to see the salvation of God today in your life.
Yes.
Because Naaman saw the power and the hand of God in his life.
Yes.
When he dipped himself 7 times.
Hallelujah.
But the simplest way we are going to tell you is just believe upon his name.
Jesus, yes.
You are going to see.
Amen.
But keep send your requests.
Amen.
Even if we are offline, we are going to pray.
Amen.
In
your
requests.
Amen. Just like today is Transformational Tuesday.
Exactly.
See, God is transforming your situation.
Exactly.
If you were worried about this virus going around, God is going to transform your situation. That's the beauty, is when you just
transform
follow the word of God. Amen.
The health of Naaman,
Amen.
It was transformed.
Amen.
Exactly.
He became a brand new person.
Hey, yes.
And so you just expect God to make something brand new. You know, God says, behold, I make all things new.
Uh-huh.
I like that. That's powerful.
That means the old has passed.
Amen.
Everything must be new in your life.
Amen.
Forget the past.
Amen. I have the testimony.
Yeah.
There's another testimony I had.
Mm-hmm.
In the middle of this situation with people all losing their jobs.
Mm-hmm.
So many people, everything wrong is happening.
Yeah.
I've just heard like 3 testimonies this week about... people getting offered jobs.
Yes.
People getting rehired.
Yes.
People getting the opposite of what everyone else is getting.
Yeah.
And they're obeying God. I just heard of someone this week that is getting a whole bunch of work for their business because God spoke to them and said, I want you to begin to tithe.
Amen.
And as they obeyed God, God opened the door that was closed.
Yeah.
No man could open it. But God made the connection.
Exactly.
Out of obedience. So we thank God for that.
Yeah.
For those testimonies.
Okay.
Well, we're going to keep praying for you guys.
Yeah, we thank God for Pastor David is watching.
Yes.
We really appreciate for that.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Pastor David, so much for joining us.
Amen.
We know your heart is in agreement with us.
Yeah, amen.
For the gospel and seeing the power of God. We bless you in Jesus' name.
We're thankful, Sister Giselle.
Yes.
In
Edmonton.
Yeah. No,
Calgary. Okay.
Yeah, we thank you for you are watching.
Yes.
Amen. We really thank you. Just continue. God is going to change.
Amen.
The life of people through this program.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Come on, we can trust God. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Well, do you have more?
For tomorrow.
Okay, guys, we're going to be back tomorrow. But we want to thank you so much for joining us tonight. And you know, please, God deserves the glory and the credit for everything.
Amen.
So even if you had a 10% increase in something is better in your life, God is answering your prayer.
Amen.
Give glory to God tomorrow.
Amen.
Let us share your testimony
so
that others who are watching can believe for them to receive from God. You know, because we trust in Him,
in
His name. We're after God. We're seeking Him with our hearts.
Amen.
We have people praying for the ministry.
Mm-hmm.
Last weekend, all night, Friday night, and Saturday night, people were interceding and praying.
Mm-hmm.
We have a team of people, guys, and We're just so honored to be with you today. We love you.
Yeah.
God loves you. If you don't know Jesus today, if you have walked away from God, and you've doubted Him, you know what? God's not here to condemn you.
Yeah.
The Father's arms are wide open. And He's just saying, come.
Amen.
Come to me.
Amen.
Come to me. You know what? There's no barrier with God. God never says that our sin is so bad and so ugly and dirty that He wants to put a barrier between us.
Amen.
Not like society is doing today. God is saying He removes the barriers by sending Jesus.
Amen.
And building a bridge.
Amen.
For us to come home. So if that's you today, recognize Jesus has done so much. All you have to do, 1 John 1:9 says, confess to God your wrongs. Whatever you know is wrong in your life, just confess it to Him, which means to agree with what the Holy Spirit convicts of. And then He is faithful and just to forgive you of all your sin and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. And just believe today that He lived the perfect life for you. He lived the righteousness of God, the holiness, and He died for your mistakes. Even the ones that we feel like are dumb mistakes, He paid for those too.
Amen.
And when He rose again the third day.
Yeah.
So when we place our faith in Him, we can be saved. We can be a child of God. Amen. It's better to be a servant in the house of God than a child in the world.
Yes.
In the devil's kingdom.
Amen.
The devil never will treat you good.
Amen.
God will treat you amazing. He loves you so much. Let Him come and transform you today.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we bless you. We thank you for joining us.
Yes.
Thank you, Pastor John.
Jesus Christ, we have prayed.
Amen.
For all the requests.
Amen. Every request, Father. Lord, we thank you for hearing it and answering them.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Why don't you just start to jump for joy?
Yes.
And give God the glory in your house.
Thank you.
Start to worship Him. Thank Him for who He is.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Pastor John, thank you so much.
Oh, thank you so much.
So honored.
Yeah. Tomorrow again we are here.
Amen.
Just be on time. 7 p.m.
I think we might have a few people joining us here in our basement.
Tomorrow. Yeah.
In our studio.
Yeah, in our studio, yeah.
Yeah, our studio. So we thank God. And on Thursday, Evangelist Joe McCray will be with us too.
Yeah, exactly.
He's
make a date
on the show
again on Wednesday.
Amen, guys.
Amen.
So we love you. Have a great night. God bless you. Keep in touch.
Amen. Thank you.